Why is my computer crashing randomly? The most common cause and a plan of attack. Hi everyone, I'm Leo Notenboom for askleo.com. If you're watching this on YouTube, be sure and hit that like button at some point if you find that this video has helped you. It's one of those things that actually helps not only me, of course, but other people who are looking for answers when they search. Let me read you today's question. My PC is not quite a year old yet, but it recently started to crash, even while just running Word. Antivirus check and everything's in order. What could possibly be the matter here? So by crash, what I mean is that your computer switches to a blue screen with all those numbers on it, black screens, it just shuts down, it reboots unexpectedly, all without warning. By far, there is one thing that causes this more than anything else. And it's where anytime you're experiencing random crashes, you want to start looking. And that is heat. Heat is the enemy. The most common cause of random crashes is an overheating computer. The most common cause of an overheating computer? Blocked airflow. The most common cause of blocked airflow? Well, around here, it's corgi fur, but in reality, it's dust and dirt blocking the vents to your desktop or laptop computer. Fans in your computer blow air through it to try and keep it cool, to try and keep it at a proper operating temperature. If the vents that they are getting their air from somehow get blocked and they can't move enough air to cool your computer, it will overheat. And when computers overheat, they start to crash. Desktop computers are certainly vulnerable to things like corgi fur and other things in the home. Laptops in particular are actually vulnerable to just being used wrong. In fact, sometimes the problem with a laptop is that you're using it in your lap, and that somehow, as part of that, that positioning is blocking the vents that allow the fans to push air through. My recommendation for most laptops is that you try and use them on some kind of a flat surface rather than your lap. After blocked vents and dirt, the next most common cause for overheating computers is still heat related. It's the fans themselves. I have several times encountered machines on whom the fan has stopped working or is just no longer working at capacity. That's one of those things where you'll actually have to take a look inside your machine, if you can, to see if the fans are running properly when it's in use. Now, it's important to realize that random isn't always completely random. The CPU inside your computer actually generates heat when it works hard. So if your computer is sitting there doing nothing, the CPU is cooler than it is when it's working hard. One of the ways to understand or at least get a clue that heat is perhaps an issue is if your computer more or less consistently crashes when it's working hard. Simply fire up Task Manager and look at the CPU meter. If that thing is pegged over 80%, 90%, 100%, and that's when your computer is reliably crashing, you're probably facing a heat issue. If it's idling during that time, there's still a possibility, but the chances are less. It's usually having to do with heat, and heat becomes the most apparent cause of crashes when the CPU is working hard. Now, I do want to mention a few other possibilities that people at least think of and that are worth looking at. To begin with, malware doesn't cause crashes as much as it used to. Back in the early days, malware was often written just to crash, just to cause problems. These days, malware is usually written in order to work properly and kind of hide behind the scenes. Crashing malware doesn't serve that purpose. So most malware authors are actually writing relatively good code that's working properly and not crashing. Failure is always an option. It is. Your computer could in fact be experiencing some kind of a hardware failure. It doesn't have to be the CPU. It could be the motherboard. It could be one of the expansion cards. It could be something else related to your computer. Unfortunately, a crash is a fairly generic thing and could be caused by a hardware failure just about anywhere in your system. Next to the fan though, failing RAM is probably the first thing that I would look at if the computer starts crashing randomly. Software is what most people think of, but the good news here is that for the most part, software, the programs you run on your machine, will not cause your entire computer to crash. The program itself may crash, but Windows will keep on running. Your other programs will keep on running. It's just that one program having a problem that might end up crashing. Now, the one exception to that rule are device drivers. Device drivers operate at a low level in your system, and yes, if a device driver crashes, it can in fact cause your entire system to crash. Again, this tends to be kind of hardware specific. Some hardware manufacturers make great drivers, some make poor drivers, some drivers just get updated periodically and they will have a problem, and sometimes they'll get updated to fix a problem. This is one of those scenarios where, once again, you want to make sure you're running the most current device drivers for the hardware that's on your machine, be that through Windows Update or through the updates made available from the computer manufacturer or hardware manufacturer themselves. But device drivers, if they're having a problem, if they're poorly written, they can cause your system to fail and crash randomly. And yes, your hard disk could cause the problem. If you've got a bad sector on your hard disk, or an intermittent sector on your hard disk, or the SSD happens to be in the process of failing, a bad read could load bad code into memory and cause the system to basically do something completely unexpected. It's rare, but it is something worth looking at, especially with a traditional hard disk, if you're suddenly seeing system slowdowns as it tries to read the disk. So here's my plan of attack. If your system is crashing randomly, here's what I suggest you do. First, make sure it has unrestricted airflow. Then make sure that it's free of dirt and dust and that the fans are all working properly. Try running a CPU temperature monitoring tool. Speccy is one that I use that is free and does this and a lot more. Run a memory diagnostic like Memtest 86. Run a hard disk diagnostic as provided either by the disk's own manufacturer or just run checkdisk/R. Make sure the operating system and the device drivers are all as up to date as possible. And of course, make sure that your security software is up to date. Hopefully, somewhere in there, your issue will get resolved. For related links, including all the software that I've mentioned, for updates and more, visit askleo.com/4437. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.